This is a map of Kenya. From here, it looks like savanna. But in reality, these areas are home to many communities.
You often think of something not on the map as being a really distant rural area. But actually, these are thriving local economies. Millions of people going about their daily lives, not captured in any data source.
In fact, places all around the world have yet to be fully mapped. And that's a huge problem.
If it's not mapped, we can never tell if people exist there. Mapping basically is notifying the rest of the world that people are here and they have needs.
And with the increase in climate-related disasters, this lack of data poses a huge risk to the most vulnerable populations, especially in the global south.
Gaps in data mean gaps in service delivery, gaps in disaster response, and that has a direct cause on human suffering and loss of life.
By collaborating with local volunteers on the ground, this team is helping communities by using open source data to literally put their citizens, roads, businesses, and buildings on the map.
The area we're working in, the home to the 1 billion most vulnerable people in our world. But there's something we can do about that. This is a problem that we can actually solve.
To solve the world's most pressing problems, we need to trust those closest to the challenge. These are the solutions that make our world a better place for everyone. This is Rethinking Possible.
Here on the ground in Turkey, unimaginable devastation. Overnight, we witnessed volunteers and workers painstakingly clearing rubble brick by brick.
When a disaster happens, local capacity is overwhelmed, and you have hundreds of people flooding into an area who aren't familiar with that place. What those people need is information about who is there, what are the strengths and what are the vulnerabilities in this community, what are the resources I have to work with.
The places most vulnerable to climate change and disasters are often the least equipped to respond. Humanitarian OpenStreetMap Team, or HOT, is changing that. 600,000 volunteers around the world are creating open source data from OpenStreetMap, or OSM, to fill in those gaps.
So mapping is a three-step process. The first stage is incredibly simple. Volunteers working anywhere in the world log in, they see a small square of satellite imagery, and they simply draw the buildings and the roads that they see. The second step, someone who's experienced will check that map, will validate it to make sure that it's accurate. The third stage, you have local people in that place coloring in the map, adding that information like place names, health centers, opening hours, so that that map becomes fully usable.
HOT focuses on mapping four regions of the world. Monica Nithka leads the Eastern and Southern Africa Hub.
As a regional office, we are really intent on ensuring that we are focusing on addressing very specific community needs.
The HOT Hubs work with a variety of partners to identify needs. Local volunteers fill in the map, and HOT provides the tech.
It's the data highways that sit behind all of the development and humanitarian interventions that are happening. We're not directly providing aid. What we're doing is making everybody who is doing that more efficient, more effective, and more confident that they're actually covering an entire population.
We use a participatory mapping process, which involves a lot of consultation with different partners and organizations.
This is damaged buildings in the floodplain, mm-hmm. And these ones are not.
And the amazing thing is that all these mapping didn't exist really before.
We had a joint project last year with HOT, and the objective was really to try to understand how OSM data could be used for climate action. So they started to do all the mapping in the communities they work, and now all that mapping is integrated within those early warning systems or anticipatory action projects that they have there.
Like many parts of the world where HOT works, Africa is no stranger to climate change either. This is an example of how one city has used HOT data for climate mitigation and to fill out the maps in their city.
Nakuru City slogan is explore, enjoy, and prosper. Welcome to Nakuru City, Kenya.
Nakuru is the third largest city in the country. Known for its diverse Kenyan population, its agriculture, approach to city planning, and flamingos, which flock to the city's four lakes. But an unfortunate consequence of the landscape is flooding, which has devastated parts of the city.
In 2022, the Eastern and Southern Africa team collaborated with the Nakuru City Board.
We were able to first train the city planners on how to digitize data on OSM. And it was such a good experience because we were able to identify the flooding zones. And with such information, we were able to draw a conclusion on how to elevate the issue.
With these insights, the city was able to secure the funding needed and properly design this drainage system.
If you can check the aerial images of this area like 2 years ago, you'll see a pool of water here. But what you can see now is a green space.
The area has improved. Even the rent has gone up, given that there's now a conducive environment for them to live within the city. And now they're going to have a decent life.
HOT has played a very significant role in making sure that we are having a strong community, and it's impactful in the entire larger scale as society, or rather Kenya's as a country.
Being able to have data generated and collected with and for communities, that continuously creates and builds trust across authorities, institutions, and the very people that we serve.
The data that we got has really helped us to better manage our city. And I believe that the quality of life that we want to improve, we are going to achieve it and become that model city that we are working towards.
Hey Monica, great to see you.
Hey, great to see you. How are you doing?
A lot of my motivation is working with communities to understand their role in contributing to data, but also their role in using this data to even make their own kind of social economic decisions.
Just having a community in Kenya where we're working with other organizations and institutions is such a good experience that it really gives hope to the coming generations that we can actually make the world a better place.
HOT has mapped a lot of the world, but communities are expanding. New infrastructure is being built, and climate disaster will hit again.
So many people use maps in their daily lives for everything. And so it's not just about disaster response, though that is absolutely critical. It's about improving people's livelihoods in all ways. So if you're sitting at home wondering how you can contribute, you can map. With something as simple as a few hours of time, you can actually contribute to real change.